The government has announced a pilot program that it hopes will boost the demand for consumer solar power, as well as relieve the burden on the nation's strained power grid. Our Polly explains how this solar panel leasing system works and how much households can save by becoming early adopters.
This apartment building in Korea is being outfitted with a solar panel, which independently generates household electricity all year round. The central government hopes it's a trend that will catch on with mainstream consumers nationwide. The Energy Ministry recently introduced a new project to promote solar power by allowing households to sidestep the initial high costs and bring a steady stream of revenue to power companies.
A specialized company will provide an all-inclusive installation where users pay a certain rental amount. This is the type of business structure that we are proposing.
According to the ministry, a single consumer solar panel is able to produce 3 kilowatts of electricity, which amounts to an average of 285 kilowatts per hour every month. That's over half the electricity an average household in Korea consumes in a single month. When looking at the economics of the program, it provides considerable savings to your energy bill. Average households in Korea pay about $150 US per month for electricity, but using a solar panel slashes that utility fee by up to 82%. Even factoring in the monthly rental costs and maintenance of the solar panel, officials say consumers stand to save up to 30% per month in power fees. The government also plans to provide incentives for companies who participate and invest in the pilot project. Local private firms, however, are taking a cautious stance due to a lack of demand in the Korean solar market. Nationwide sales of solar power-related equipment peaked at just over $1 billion in the first quarter of this year, representing a sharp decline of 42% from 2012. The solar panel rental program is scheduled for a test run later this year, with a national mandate to increase solar power generation by 20% by 2015. Paul Yi, Arirang News.